Hello everybody, Shadefyre here, and welcome back to Let's Play Resident Evil 7. This is Episode 7. Last time we more thoroughly explored the old house and got into a few altercations with Marguerite, who then fell into a pit with her little bug lamp and became some sort of horrible cricket monster or something and ran off. So now we need to face her down so we can steal her lamp and get through the door in order to get the D-series arm we need to make our cure. We also got a magnum and a grenade launcher. And I think we're ready for some real combat. Which is good, because I think that Marguerite coming up is one of the hard fights that people were talking about with this game, somewhere that people had trouble. So let's see here. We're going to want to be prepared. Take this first aid med. Strong chem fluid, 78. Wow, you only get one grenade from that, so these must be pretty powerful then. I mean, I did waste one of them last time. I accidentally fired it into Marguerite's stupid face when I was trying to switch weapons. I'm wondering if I should bring the magnum as well. I feel like we're already kind of over-equipped for this fight. I don't want to bring the shotgun though, because I feel like we're going to waste ammo for the shotgun without really having too much effect on her. Yeah, the problem is I don't really know what I'm preparing for here. I don't know if, like, we should be bringing fire, or if I should ditch the flamethrower. I mean, if she can still summon bugs, I should probably keep the flamethrower just to keep them off me, but if she can't, then it'll just be wasting space. Got a lot of gunpowder as well. But I only have one chem fluid. So I can make bullets. I can make more healing. I don't really need more healing, though. We've got a lot of healing on us still. In fact, I'll probably take out this strong med that we got really early on from that supply box. Should I take the defense coin? I feel like the defense coin is cheating. That's easy mode. Whatever. Maybe this is a bad idea, but, you know, gotta play the game my own way. We'll make another grenade. What else can we use gunpowder for? We can make strong bullets and weak bullets, and I wonder if that's it. Chem fluid. I probably should have made one of these. I think that's maybe this game's equivalent of the acid rounds from other Resident Evils. Okay, so we'll make the bullets and deposit the gunpowder. And we're just going to save over... just so I don't have to do all that inventory sorting when I probably die. Alright, here we come, Marguerite. Not that way, though. This way. I'm hoping this will be one of those cases where I'm actually over-equipped for the boss. But you never know. Also, I don't know if I thoroughly looked around here. Okay, there's a path that leads into the swamp or something on the other side. The flamethrower also kind of provides a nice little close-range light if we're trying to look for stuff. Alright. That's not the right way. Can we get? Oh, through here. Is this not where we came from? Guess not. No, because we climbed out through, like, a hole in the ground or something. That's not a good sound. That sounds like it's probably Marguerite, though, because there was a lantern creaking as well. What do we got up here? Alright, small key. Or lockpick that we need. Some herbs. Some more fuel. So it looks like they're also trying to prepare us for this fight. Separating agents. Yeah, so it seems like with this we could just break down any of the stuff that is made from combining. Which is not really that useful. I kind of wish I hadn't picked that up right now. Once more into the breach. Okay, she's probably through there. You know, left her spider marks on the door. Gate is blocking the way. Okay, we can't burn the stuff holding it. Hidden under there. It might actually be worth trying to find the rest of those coins so we can get the... what was it? Stabilizer? Because if we want to get the double-barrel shotgun, then it might be worth having a faster reload. Can I go through here? No. Doesn't look like there's anything hidden down there either. That door's locked. And sounds like it's probably covered with spiders on the other side. Psychostimulants. Locked on the other side. So there's actually a fair amount of rooms here. I thought we were going to be dropping straight into a boss fight. Yeah, there's the spiders. Shit, I wish I had looked around here before we went outside. Can I drop this? Or like... Okay, I can discard it. Again, maybe that's wasteful, but whatever. Take the strong chem fluid. And... I can make a better heal or another grenade. I should probably make another heal, because I don't know how much I'm going to need here. And I can take the shotgun shells. Maybe I should have taken the shotgun with me after all. I don't even think it was worth doing that. I mean, as it stands right now, I don't even really have enough ammo for this thing for it to be useful.
We're gonna settle this!
My Marguerite, long arms you got. All the battle to strangle you to death with. More solid fuel. Maybe I should be mixing some flamethrower ammo if it's going to keep giving me more fuel. It's a random broken ladder that doesn't seem to go anywhere. What are you doing, creepy? Oh, I might have just triggered the fight, didn't I? Ugh. Is she just, like, full of bugs now? That's not what I meant to pull out. Gotta watch these holes in the roof so she doesn't drop down on me. I was debating going back for the shotgun, but I guess it's too late now. Burner fuel. Shit. Oh, if I reload my gun, that should free up a spot. up. That thing attacked my frame rate directly. Oh boy. Alright. Oh, that was a hole in the floor I just fell through. We're not really that restricted in where we can go here. Oh boy. Shit. I really gotta look at the floor. This is a weird boss fight. It's very open. It seems that we can kind of fight her in this entire house. More fuel. Bullets. Now I wonder if that sound she made there was because she runs off and regenerates. And then I'm supposed to chase her down. I hope that wasn't a waste there. Where did the other one go? Just sort of disappeared. More burner fuel. Did we get her? I don't think she's dead, but I think we ended the fight when I hit her with that last grenade. And that's why that bug just kind of disappeared. Nope, here she comes. Ugh. This is a dead end. All right, I can grab that burner fuel now. If I can remember where it was. I think it was... It's getting darker, too. The thing is, without the flamethrower, I don't think I can do anything about the swarm. Like, they'll just follow me forever. Not what I was looking for. This is pretty hectic.
There's no escape, city boy!
I'm not really sure how to kill her, though. I mean, with Jack we had a pretty decisive weapon to use. Ow. That hurt. A lot.
You're not getting away this time.
Yeah, and blocking isn't going to help me against the swarm. There, I took out the nest and her in one shot. Anything here we can use against her to actually finish her off? Because, I mean, we're getting a lot of ammo and stuff. Oh, come on. Fucking on fire bug. That was my last healing item. Nope, got one more. Ow. According to an achievement, you can shoot her out of the air when she does that, but probably not with a pistol. Alright, all I got left now is herbs, so I might as well mix some more fucking shit. Running out of options here. Those just came through the wall. Back. Oh, shit. Double shit. I think we're screwed at this point.
The brave pull out the truth!
Yeah. because I think I am screwed. I'm going to use a psychostimulant, see if there's anything left I missed. Yeah, it doesn't look like I missed anything else. That knife is so bad. That's alright. I don't think I adequately prepared because I should have brought the fucking shotgun. So, let's do that. Alright, I didn't even notice it last time, but as I was running by here, I saw there's a treasure photo stuck to the stairwell. And I want to say that's the bathroom back in the trailer, so let's just pop back there for a second. See what kind of treasure awaits. Otherwise, it's back in the house. Is there even a toilet in here? Is that it? Yeah, there's the cigarette butts. Alright, so the treasure was 3 magnum bullets. Which I guess we won't use for this fight. So my idea here is, because I don't have 4 slots, I will use the grenade launcher first, and then when that runs out, we'll use the shotgun. Which hopefully will be enough to finish her off. Alright, let's get into the actual fight. Alright, here we go. I'm gonna be a little bit more discerning about what I pick up this time, instead of just picking up everything. Like, I don't need those psychostimulants right now, they're just wasting space. And with the shotgun, that means space is even more limited now than it was before. We got plenty of grenades for now, and they do seem to hurt her quite a bit. Let's just kill it with fire. To grab that handgun ammo, because now I have 2 stacks. Oh, she missed. So she created this shortcut. This ladder was just kind of sitting here doing nothing before. She's gonna be right behind me. Nope, I guess she climbed up to the ceiling. Oh, she's down there. Don't stand too close, because you can probably grab us again. Alright, continue the fiery assault. I think I missed with that one. I actually don't know how to equip this. How the hell do you switch what's equipped? I can't drag. Oh, hit it R. There we go. So I think that, like, birthing sound she makes is when she makes a new nest. What's actually in this room? Shells. Ah! slap there. Here's the thing, with having these, you know, kind of invincible regenerating enemies, I'm always kind of hesitant to use my ammo, because I don't know if I'm just wasting it. Like, if I'm supposed to be looking for some way to kill her, aside from just shooting her a bunch. Yeah, with those bugs, you really just gotta wait till they stop moving. She got a good hit on me there, but I didn't die.
I'm gonna kill you! I'm gonna kill you! I'm gonna kill you!
Still, that was my first heal, so I guess we're doing pretty good this time. I hope she's almost done, because, you know, we're running low on ammo. There's still some around that I haven't picked up. Like, I don't think I've picked up any burner ammo yet. Shit, gotta reload. Oh man, that's just instantly almost dead every time. Just trying to see if there's any more stuff I missed on the ground here. Should be some more fuel there. Is that it?
Fucking stay dead, okay?
And somehow she ended up with the lantern inside her, which I guess is why she could just squirt out more bugs. I don't suppose I can hang on to this and become the bug master. Alright, well that was tough, but, you know, pulled it off in the end. I think really just my mistake the first time was not bringing the shotgun, because I thought I would save it in case we have to deal with more molders. Molders. I'll get that right eventually. Alright. There's probably still a few things lying around here that I didn't pick up this time, like the psychostimulants, but I don't have space for them. And there's a few herbs as well. Can I open this? No. I suppose I could do that. Might have wanted to save that for more fire grenades, but whatever. And this lets us get back outside. So now we can take the lantern back into the other side of the house and get the arm. But first, let's do some inventory management. Okay, we'll deposit the grenade launcher. Don't have any more grenades right now anyway. I guess we'll deposit the shotgun, the heavy heal, solid fuel. I'll keep the chem fluid and I'll make another heal. Because I have some herbs in here somewhere. And I'll deposit the shotgun for now. And I think we should have enough time to go do this lantern business and hope that it doesn't trigger anything too dramatic. Can't get into the main house from here. Need to go back the other way. I do like the way that this game kind of all interconnects like this, you know. Opens up these sort of like Dark Souls shortcuts back to main hub. Because, I mean, I would say Zelda for shortcuts like that, but Zelda's always more shortcuts to get from the end of the dungeon back to the beginning. They don't generally don't have new areas that you open up to access from the hub. I know there's no bobblehead there, but I still can't help but look. Alright, so we've dealt with two of the bakers now. That just leaves the son, Lucas, and the, I suppose, the source of this whole outbreak, Eveline. What was that piano sting? Oh, that's somebody playing a piano, turns out. I suppose we've also got Grandma Baker. Keep forgetting about her, but she's still kicking around, and she probably has some significance at some point. Creepy child's room. Or perhaps just storage of child's stuff. Okay, I guess none of that stuff's important. Yep, there's Eveline and her family of moldy people. Eveline. So is this just where they stuck her when she showed up? Like, hey, you're gonna live in this decrepit room. Even though you're basically the master of this house now. Home. They killed him. Wartime photojournalism. I wonder if that's a Dead Rising reference. Living well. Unnerving combat. Mounted animals. What? Gross. Murder in Cleveland. Heartless betrayal. Beautiful home. Sudden mystery. Fighting street. Creator's Rights, Louisiana. Quite a eclectic collection of books there. And moldy dolls. And I guess that's the broken ship that she arrived in. All right, moldy teddy bear. Well, this doesn't look like imminent danger for us. I'm trying to carefully look out for items, but it doesn't seem like there's anything here. You think we wouldn't want to touch that mold, considering that's probably the same growth that, creates the moldeds and the baker's regenerative abilities. Oh, good.
Stay away.
But Eveline, I'm your daddy now. Lucas said so. I am curious what the deal with that shriveled corpse in the suitcase was all about. If that was the original soul source of the mold that Eveline carries. Because, I mean, it seems safe to assume now that she was probably some company's BOW in development. Okay, so this is a map showing that there's a secret in the wall. Alright, I think we have finally found this arm. And it didn't even cost us an arm and a leg. Well, it did cost us an arm at one point. But, there's also a scene that I didn't trigger, I was going to say, about the leg, where when Jack is chasing you around early on, like after the dinner table scene, he can catch you and just, he cuts your leg off with a shovel, and then tosses you a, he makes you crawl to grab a healing thing, and then you just kind of like glue your leg back on using the healing solution. It's a bit wacky. And who's this dead fella then?
Oh god, I guess this is it.
I guess we just have to take whatever's about to happen here. Oh no, she ran off. Thought she was gonna own us. We actually saw these circles very early on in the basement as we were first coming into the house. Oh, hold her. Damn, that did a lot of damage. Well, I wasn't expecting to die from that, of all things, but even the regular enemies in this game are pretty dangerous. Thankfully, the game is pretty generous about checkpointing, so it just stuck us back in the spooky room. to watch out for that lunge forward they do when they're damaged. Alright, don't know how he missed. Alrighty. He's probably not the only one we're gonna have to deal with on the way out here. Which is shitty, because I really didn't equip for this. Should have kept the shotgun. I can see where this is where people would have said to turn the brightness up. In fact, let me do that now. Alright, adjusted the brightness just a little notch up so I can see a little better here, because even with the flashlight, it's not great. Oh god, I just got really turned around for a second. It might have actually been a better idea just to run past that one. Don't want to run into a basement situation, though, where I get stuck in a room with like four of them. There's another one up ahead. We shouldn't have a reason to come back up here, so it doesn't matter if we leave him behind.
Did you find it?
Yeah, I got it. Are we really going to be able to make serum with this thing?
It'll be fine. After we make it, we can get out of here. Together. I'll be waiting for you in the trailer.
Alright.
I mean, I've already got a wife, Zoe. You gotta go your own way. I think now is probably a good time to head back and save. Next time, or actually before next time, I'll go back through the greenhouse area and pick up anything I missed and, you know, do some inventory shuffling.
Where the hell are you? You know, never mind. We only need the head, and you've got it. This is gonna help me and me, right?
Hey, buddy! I thought you should know. I decided that Zoe needed a timeout. She and Mia are here with me. And they're keeping each other company.
Just let them both go! What do you need them for?
That's family business, Ethan, and not your concern, understand? Now, if you want the head, feel free to come by any time and I'll give it to you. But only if you participate in a little, activity I've put together just for you.
What activity?
Oh, I know you're excited, but don't worry. It's not going anywhere. First step I need you to take, partner, is for you to take a peek inside the fridge in the trailer there.
Fuck you!
Oh, come on now, don't be like that. You want to have some fun, don't you? Now, look in the fridge.
His voice seems to change a bunch from the three times we've heard it before. Well, there's a head. Ah, this is the police officer's head. which has now grown a mouth out of where it was cut off. So he's presumably turning into a molded now that he's dead. Or the mold is turning his body into a molded. But, sounds like we need to go back down to the basement. Alright, let's save. That was a bit of a long one again, but again, I'm intrigued about this game and I want to continue, so that's why I kind of end up running a little too long. I just want to keep going. Anyhow, I'm Shadefyre, that's Resident Evil 7, and I hope you'll join me next time when we go look around in the basement for the dead body, I guess? Hopefully he has a treasure for us. Till then, take care, folks.